Lincoln's a happy, agile, spry boy. When people come to our house, he's the one that's jumping on them and greeting them. He likes to steal things off the counter, so he's mischievous and fun, but he loves life.
Last year, Lincoln had a cancer on his front paw. The whole leg had to be amputated. As part of his routine follow-up, he gets chest radiographs. And just one day we brought him in for his routine follow-up, and he had a very large amount of fluid on his lungs. The fluid was sampled. This was in Orlando, and it was kind of inconclusive. And so because we've been coming to University of Florida for many years with other dogs, we immediately said, we need to talk to somebody here and get a second opinion. One of the experts here at University of Florida is Dr. Brad Case. Immediately took over the case. First, he had a CT scan, which showed a mass.
And it's blocking one of the major veins that drains his heart, and that's why the lymph is getting blocked and the fluid is draining into his lungs.
Dr. Case felt very strongly that this would be something that the radiation oncologist, Dr. Shiomitsu, would be able to take a good look at with the new technology that was just starting here.
The Variant Edge is the name of the new linear accelerator that we've obtained. The exciting thing about the Variant Edge is that it's going to increase our ability to treat tumors that are near important structures in the body that we're trying not to harm. In this particular case, we are treating a tumor in the chest where when the patient is breathing, it's going to cause the organs near the tumor to move. The capabilities that this machine has allow us to adjust for the motion that occurs while the patient's breathing, in that way to minimize the damage to the surrounding structures. That has really opened up new possibilities for us.
Now, unfortunately, no, we do not have no definitive diagnosis on Lincoln. However, so we suspect he has no neuroendocrine tumor. So neuroendocrine tumor, in general speaking, this is a radiosensitive tumor. When we see tumor response for this type of tumor, usually we see tumor response 6 to 8 months download. We already see some tumor shrinkage, so which is not really positive. So we would expect good prognosis for Lincoln.
Lincoln has been doing awesome. He's as active as he ever has been.
Our hopes for him is that this delays any kind of spread of the tumor. We hope the actual tumor itself remains a little bit smaller and not pushing on the lymph so the fluid doesn't come back in his lungs. We just really hope it gets him some longer quality of life as well as quantity of life.